हेलो एंड वेलकम टू पार्ट टू ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ड्राइंग पेपर सॉल्यूशन जुलाई 2009। माई सेल्फ अर्पण पंडित, आई एम फ्रॉम आत्मिया कॉलेज। वील सी फर्दर क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द क्वेश्चन पेपर रिमेनिंग। नाउ लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट द क्वेश्चन नंबर टू। अगेन दिस प्रॉब्लम इज ऑफ ड्रॉइंग टू व्यूज, दैट्स ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन। We need to draw bottom view and the rear view from the given figure. Now, as you can see in the problem, we cannot see any sort of clearness is given in this problem, so that we are independent to use the projection method and we are independent to use any dimension system. We can either use first angle or third angle projection, and we can either use unidirectional or aligned dimension system. Now let's have a look at the figure from which we need to plot the bottom view and the rear view. So this is the figure given. We need to draw bottom view and rear view in respect with this x arrow. So from this it would be front view. So bottom view will be looking like from over here, and rear view from this portion it would be top view. So rear view would be from this side. Only difference between the top view and the rear view would be the only thing that let's consider taking it from the top view itself. But in the top view everything would be visible, whether from the rear view everything would be in the hidden line itself, anything won't be visible clearly. So everything would be in the hidden line itself. Let's plot the two views first of all. Let's draw a reference line first of all. First of all, I am drawing the bottom view and I am using the first angle projection method. So bottom view will come in the top side. I have drawn a reference line. Let's have a look at the figure first of all. If you look at the figure, you will find that you need to take this 20 mm line, 20 by 100 rectangle you will see first of all. First of all we will draw a line of 100 mm. Let's draw from the leftmost portion of the page itself so that rear view can also be accommodated accordingly. This line is of 100 mm. height, this line would be of 80 mm. First of all we are going to draw a 100 mm line. Height of the same would be 20 mm. So we can plot a 20 by 100 rectangle now. We'll take midpoint of the same 100's mid point will come around 50 mm. We'll take a perpendicular center line. Perpendicular center line. Now, if you look at the figure, you will find out that a circle center is located at 80 mm from this 20. If you look, this height is given as 20, and from this 20 point, this circle's center is located at 80 mm. So, mark a point at 80 mm. You got the point. Now, if you look at the figure once again, then you will see that the dimension of a circle is given as diameter 40 and diameter 70. So, diameter 40 will come around as radius 20. Diameter 70 comes around as radius 35 with the same center. With using the same center, take a horizontal center line as well. Take a horizontal center line as well. Now, if you look at the figure once again, then you will find that 2 rib is tangent to the circle. So, we need to draw 2 tangent line. Tangent line means that intersecting to the circle at single point only. Like this. Now, if you look at the figure, you will see that we are drawing a rear view. So, everything would be hidden now onwards, because we cannot see this rib, neither we can see this cylinder. So, everything would be hidden portion now onwards. The rib dimension is given as 12 mm around the center. So, 6 mm either. Now, if you look at this cylinder, cylinder height is given as 12 mm plus 2 diameters have been given, diameter 50 and diameter 32. You have been given diameter 32 and diameter 15, whereas the height is given as 12 mm. So, in the figure, first of all, we'll take a 12 mm line, 12 mm point mark, and diameter 50, which means that 25 mm on either side, it would be a hidden line. One more dimension, diameter 32 has been given, which means that 16 on either side, like this, this view can be constructed. So this is how you can draw a rear view of a drawing. This is our rear view. Now with respect to this only, we are going to draw bottom view. We need to draw bottom view in respect to this only. Now if you look at the figure, in the bottom view, total height, total length would be 75 plus 50. So we will have a rectangle of 125 by 100. So we will draw a rectangle of 125 by 100. Now in the bottom view, anything would be visible, everything would be in the hidden line itself. Now we'll plot this. First of all, we'll plot this 50 radius, then these two cylinders. For that we need to take the center points. Fifty as radius. This would be visible and this portion will be erased. Making it darker so that consideration can be proper. So this would be the thing. Now diameter 50, we can take projections from here. It would be a hidden line circle only. As it cannot be clearly visible from the bottom view, and diameter 32, again this would be in the hidden line itself. Let's draw a center line once more. Now let's see about this projection. As you can see, from the center portion we are having two diameters of diameter 70 and diameter 40. So diameter 70 will come around as 35 on either side. From this, on both the side, it would be 15 mm would be clearly visible, whether 15 mm would be hidden. This portion would be in the hidden line. So this is how you can construct. One more thing remaining: rib of 12 mm, which means that 6 mm on either side, again that would be in the hidden line itself. So this is how, and look, bottom view will look like. All the dimension need to be given. First of all, let's give dimension to the rear view.